Sarah. I'm 17 years old and I'm from Melbourne. The first song I'll be singing for you guys today is Kick It Up by The McClymonds. Feel free to put your feet up. Thank you.
Now's gonna take a little bit more than the average to weigh it down. It's been one of those weeks I'd rather forget about. Get a plastic sheet for the bed of your truck, fill it full of beer and ice. Do you pass your wife and lazy husband, cause no one's going home tonight. You got a razor bar, take it up in my car, a whole new level of breathing in. Another notch. This party ain't for shrinking violence. Give it all you got. Ooh, ooh. Pass me the spotlight. Let's get this mother up another notch. Now the red pass is out of the first. It's time to achieve. And if you jump out of water, gotta be naked as a breeze. Out in the field there's a beat-up car that set the leaf on fire. We stay out until the sun goes down and we have to get up in the wild. We gotta elevate, we'll ever return to a whole new level of breathing in. So kick it up another night.
Daddy's over the hills, but we're all gonna die.
performing for you is Happier by Ed Sheeran on piano. My light piano skills, I've just started this year, but I'm getting there. Riptide by Vance Joy. I was scared of dentists and a dog. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. Oh, all my friends are turning green. You're the magician's assistant in the dreams. Ooh, ooh, and they come unstuck.
this guy decides to quit his job and heads to New York City. This cowboy is running from himself. She's been living on the high shelf.
There's something I've learned in these past few weeks. I've really fallen for you, oh honey, I adore you. It's the red hair, the dry sense of humor, that cheeky little laugh. I swear to God, there's nothing cuter. If I could hold you all day long, there would be no wrong. It's a simple sensation with the perfect combination. Let me go. I'm going crazy, baby. You amaze me. I don't care if we take things slow. Just never let me go. Another day has passed. I'm still in a trance. Your love has me firing, baby. Working as hard as time, baby. Fighting for your attention, but forever fearing rejection. No matter how hard I try, there's no certainty of mine. Other girls have it so easy, their beauty is oh so dreamy. But their attention isn't value, I don't feel for you like I do. Can't you see I love you more than I could tell you? Hold me close. Let me go. I'm going crazy, baby. You amaze me. I don't care if we take things slow. Just never let me go. Can't you see I love you? Can't you see I care for you? Can't you see there's nothing keeping me from sharing it? Let me go. I'm going crazy, baby. You amaze me now. So hold me close. Never let me go. I'm going crazy, baby. You amaze me. I don't care if we take things slow. Just never let me go.
Thank you very much. Have you a good night.
Sarah, great performance. I really loved it. I think you've got a beautiful voice, kind of a classic pop kind of feel to your voice for me. I thought you could do so many songs. There's so many songs that would suit your voice in that pop kind of genre. And I liked the country feel too. I thought you did country really well. You've got a voice that's very suited for that as well. So all in all, really good. But things for you to work on, because that's what we're here for. Not only to tell you how great you are, but also to give you a few things to work on. My biggest criticism was the tuning of your instrument to start off with. I thought that really sort of hampered your performance. So just sometimes it might be a little bit, you might feel the pressure to just perform in those situations and ignore the fact that your instrument's out of tune. And really I would advise that you take the time on stage to do that and just apologize and say, I just got to quickly tune up and do it, because the audience will end up thanking you for it in the end. And you'll sing better. You'll be able to perform better because you don't have that thing going on, that battle going on in your mind about between pitch of you that you know is right, because you've got really great pitch, and battling with your instrument. And also it's more pleasant for everyone out the front, of course. And the other thing I just wanted to say was, just be a little bit careful of saying negative things about your skill levels. Like you mentioned something about not being great at piano, and even though that was kind of lovely and honest, and in a way that's a way of engaging is with honesty, I would just advise against that with pertaining to your musical skills, because it just sort of piques people's interest in being a little bit more judgmental and more critical of that element. So, you know, I found myself listening more to your piano, trying to find the mistakes and trying to find proof. Basically, I'm just trying to prove what you've told me by picking on that rather than listening to the vocal thing. Is you've drawn attention to it, whereas really if you're not feeling great about your skills on something, I would do anything to distract people from that. So putting on a great vocal performance and not mentioning the piano would probably be a better way of going about that, because that'll keep everyone's attention on what your strengths are rather than pulling their attention to your weaknesses. But, you know, there's no harm done. It was beautiful and honest, and I thought you were really courageous to do a song with piano, given this that you've only been playing for a little while, and you actually did really good. So, you know, maybe that'll give you more confidence for next time to not have to mention it. So well done. I'll hand you over to Ed. I'm sure he's got more to say.
Yep. So just adding to what Tim said, the first song you did, Kick It Up, I think, the McClimates, I really liked, just what Tim was saying about you do the country thing, the modern country thing, really quite well. Even had a little bit of a yodel lilting quality to your voice, which a lot of people spend years trying to get at, but you seem to just have it automatically, along with your ability to pitch. You've got a great sense of pitch. I was even amazed that even though your uke was a bit out of tune, you still maintained your own pitch in your own key, which tells me that you've just got that. You're so many steps ahead of a lot of other people because you can do that. I can't do that. So that's really great. Some of us have to work really hard to maintain even pitch. You just do it naturally. I really liked your interaction with us. Good that you were sort of introducing all the songs, and you're very expressive and, you know, including us into the show as well, which is always really good. Unfortunately those little things like a uke being out of tune can throw the audience a little bit, even though, you know, 80% of people say that they're tone deaf. They're not really. They just never know how to articulate it, but we all can feel when something's a bit out of tune. It's pretty simple. Even if it delays the show by 10 seconds or something, or delays a song by 10 seconds, just get onto that tuning. There's a lot of really cheap tuners now. You can just attach them to the neck of your uke or your guitar and just away you go, get that sorted. There was another thing. When you're working with a backing track, that's when I felt your pitch was most strongest, but the backing track itself, which is completely fine, a lot of people do it these days, it was a little bit compressed, therefore it was a little muddy, and your voice was clear compared to the backing track, so it did feel a little bit disjointed. When you get in the backing track, try and get the best quality you can that's not compressed. Like, it's a technical thing, but it's a good thing to get on top of as a singer. Other than that, yeah, really enjoyed your show. You've got a lot of potential. Sort out those other little things, and yeah, that'll be great.
How did you feel her mic technique was?
I wasn't really thinking about that, to be honest. What about
it wasn't too bad. I think I've found a theme with most performances today, but the mic technique, you can maybe work on that a little bit. You're pretty good with it, but it's a refinement thing, you know, just really working that mic to make sure that your delivery is quite even out the front.
And it is that thing of, as you're going louder, I mean, it's every singer's different singers use different mics, so it's a thing that'll take a bit of time, but it means that your front of house person isn't chasing you with limiters and compressors to try to keep things even. The more you can do, it's not about helping the sound person, don't worry about the sound people, but it's more about just being a professional and being able to sing and have control over their gear, because it's just a nice thing to do to have that technique down. Yeah. Okay. Thanks.